folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to on deleting MinIO objects using the Go language. And in this video, we're going to be using Go version 1.19. We're going to be deleting objects from play.min.io, which is our online sandbox where anybody can work with the MinIO platform. And we're going to be running all of this out of VS Code. By the end of this video, you should be comfortable using the remove object function and also working with the remove object options struct. Let's take a look at some code. And here we've got our main package along with our main function. I've done a few imports of some packages here, including a MinIO demo functions package, as well as the MinIO Go API package. My first step here in my main function is to call out PlayConnect. This is going to set up a bucket for me and also some content that I can actually use to delete without causing any problems. And what I'm going to do first is I'm going to delete a backup image that is already out on play.min.io. Now, when you call remove object, you need to give it the bucket name and the object name, which I've set here. I'm also calling out this remove object options. Now, for right now, there aren't any options set. We're going to take a look at that in just a moment. But I also need to have this background context in order to functionally call the remove object function. So, with that context in mind, when I run this, the only thing the remove object might show me is an error. So I'm actually going to be showing you what's out on play.min.io right now using the MinIO command line client MC. So let me go ahead and show you what we've got. If I do an MC LS, and I'm going to do a recursive on play our Go demo bucket. If I show you this, you can see that I've got three objects out there right now. I've got my backup image, a hello world text, and an image PNG. So let's go ahead and run this code, which is designed to delete that backup image. So if I go ahead and run it with a go run dot, I don't get any output. Fortunately, I also don't get any errors. But now if I run this MC ls-r play go bucket, my backup image is gone. And also, while I'm at it, my backup prefix is gone because there are no objects left in that prefix anymore. So let's go ahead and take a look at some versions. If I do this MC LS with versions enabled on my play go demo bucket, what you will see is that I have a bunch of versions out there right now. And there's my backup prefix, it's got nothing in it. But I've got a bunch of versions out there right now, 15 of them to be exact. So what do I do if I want to actually delete a specific version of one of these objects? So what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to change my object name that I'm deleting from backup image. I'm going to change it to image PNG, and I'm going to delete version 8 right here. And the way that I do that is I'm going to use this version ID. Where does the version ID go? Right here in the remove object options, version ID, and I'm going to give it a string. That string is going to be this version ID here. I'm just going to copy paste it. And notice that before that version, I've got 115D, and after that version, I've got B7B2, because now when I run this one more time, go run dot, and I do that MCLS with versions again. Well, I still have a version 8, but notice the one version that I had before, 2AC, is now gone. I've got 115D and B7B2 now surrounding it. I also only have 14 versions of image PNG, but I have 15 versions of Hello World, which is what we had before. So this is how you can actually delete a particular version off of MinIO using the Go language. I hope you've enjoyed this little how-to. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods that you see here on the screen. You can also chat with us interactively on slack.min.io, or you can just leave us a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.